60 of Horizon Zero Dawn. In the last episode, we went to like around here with it or wherever. Or no, we went from there through these like this maze of cave systems where there were demonic stalkers. And then over here, and now we're here.
Warmth feels like out here.
Just one more machine. The Frostclaw. Epsilon overrides. It's the body, freeze sack, freeze unit. Disables the freeze sack with claws. Disables all freeze based attacks other than the claws. Power cell. Yeah.
I didn't get to show you anyway, it's a cool freeze attack.
Machine down.
It does have some.
Now back to finding Araya. Which means we've gotta climb.
Hey, just look at the snow. Like, even the machine makes like holes of tracks in the snow. It's really cool.
Should be able to get up there.
Just have to climb up there. I like the. Oh wow, we are, over that mountain, we'd be quite close to a Thunderjaw site.
Oh,
Yep. There it is. There's the Thunderjaw. Can barely see it through the snow. We can see a bit better there. Yep. Oh, I forgot to start the timer. Say it's been 5 minutes, so ends the episode at 2:25. Oh, I go up here. Okay, well this is a bit scary. Volcano over there, maybe? So snowy, I can't tell. Or is this ash? Oh, this might be ash from the volcano.
This must be the shrine Neltuk was talking about. Guess I should take some blue gleam.
Bird. I think that's a storm bird.
Neltuk said Aurea went past the shrine up into the mountain. I'd better take those stairs.
What's there? Oh. Yeah, even like the little bits of snow or whatever. Like, look! Right. Oh, come on, this is totally a thing. Oh yeah, see? There. Maybe it's these arrows. Yeah, you know. Yeah, like, look at that. I love the snow up here. The music is not bad at all either. Oh, now it clears up. And Dritten and Glory can't see it. Oh, wow, that's pretty. Like, look at the mountains over there. The way they're arrayed. Oh, it's amazing. I'm pretty sure like those mountains are like these. Wow, that music.
An ancient door. Maybe Aurea's inside.
is retreat.
March 10th, 2046. I just spent 16 hours in here trying to install upgrades to improve efficiency for the central processing unit. Project Firebreak is going to need the brain power. Let's just hope I'll have enough of my own. Anita stayed with me the whole time. We got a lot done, but every time she brushed by and I smelled her hair... Oh boy, I should just go to bed.
Lots of strange equipment. What was this place?
Was it indeed?
This is Director of Security Blevins resending the emergency supply order. Try reading it this time, okay? You weasels don't want me calling my people in SLC. Message text.
Two thousand MREs in Ozonia. 30 military-grade flashlights and portable water pumps. 50 tubes of fungicide. 15 hydraulic jacks, 12 replacement drone propulsion units, 50 holographic micro drives, 50 almond scented extra soft data corrupted.
Director of Security Blevins is riding us like a petty tyrant. I can't even sneeze without triggering his control issues.
Blevins reconfigures the pattern on the lambent orbicular door access one more time. I'm going to violate my teleport. I'm sure I don't want some gift shop employee rooting around in the Firebreak facility, but these measures aren't about security, they're about control. I wonder if Blevins gets in early to watch everyone try to solve the new pattern, perched over his little camera array in his big boy office. What a bridge toll. Thanks. Action of his fancy drone budget to go towards buying him some classier body spray. But help me and Kenny if he ever finds out about us. The door again. Okay, so I've been hearing that some of our staff members are having trouble with our state-of-the-art, ultra-secure, and absolutely necessary lambent orbicular door access. So here's the SLOW version again. The thingy in the middle is the source node. Turn it on. Yeah, I know. Hard, right? Then you've got to turn the other node so that the data stream containing your credentials gets back to the source. Some nodes are used to buffer corrupt or suspect data, so avoid those. Shouldn't be too tough, because, you know, they're red. Like a stop sign. I'm guessing you were taught this in preschool, but with this crowd, who knows? Anyway, that's it. Get the data stream back to the source, and the door opens. It's really not that tough, but if you need me to, I'll hold your hand while you give it a try. Actually, scratch that. Do it yourself. I'm not going to touch your hand.
For the door.
Override source node.
Something. What am I supposed to do with these lights?
So avoid the red ones.
These things turn, changing the flow of light.
This is a pretty easy one.
All right, let's see if the door's open.
Nope. I get it. That is a cool door. Now we climb. It's obviously not that way.
Fresh air ahead.
Dorinda is trying to slide into the thing. It's faster. Oh, I guess we could roll. There's that way. Or there's this way.
Out again. Maybe I can get back inside through that structure over there.
Let's try going over this way. Oh, dead end. Wow. Look at that path. It goes along the ridge. Everyone's went on a pretty easy,
like
it was
to get to those stairs.
Easy hiking trail, but it went over a river. Can't fast travel you too close to the destination. Don't want to
feels
fall
like if
down
I blink,
there.
My eyes will freeze shut.
Okay. That looks like a thing we can grab onto. Yep. Must be slippery up here. The ice. Look at that.
Not much higher to climb. Maria must be close.
Wow. Way down there. So it's hidden behind these mountains.
She has to be in here somewhere.
Stage 2 complete. The completion of the first level of infrastructure on our primary facility. This compound will be the nerve center for our project and will require the team's continued best efforts to realize by the deadline. But even though there is much more to be done, you should be pleased with all you've accomplished so far. Please find a detailed plan for mustering out of the auxiliary space, which will serve as a contingency site as we proceed to the main facility. 90% of our personnel must be relocated by 5 p.m. Wednesday. If your name is not currently assigned to us, please email Marissa with me in CC. Your dedication, talent, and intelligence remain daily sources of inspiration. Dr. Kenny Chow, Project Director.
Someone hacked the menu board to display obscene messages about our colleague, Mr. Blevins. Is this the most advanced geological project ever undertaken, or a junior high locker room? Come on, people.
From Kenny Chow to Anita Sandoval. Subject for hacking menu board. Anita, was it you? Wink. Here we go.
Ask again, as I've asked 1,000 times. Speak to me. What more would you have me do? Is there no prayer that will reach you? No mark that will break your bonds? I can't help you if you won't speak! A whisper is all I ask. To guide me. Who? No. How? How did you get here? The way was sealed by the spirit herself.
I used one of these. I could show you.
Yes, show me. Please.
Well. Activate the source node.
But I'll bet the goal's the same. Get the light back to the source.
A lot more nodes. This one's actually a bit of a puzzle. Let's see here. Does that work? Oh. Security measures. I'm sure you're painfully familiar with the process by now. I guess I'll try to arrange these into a cool thumbnail.
Oh. Yeah, this one is really... Well, yeah, I think I'll end this episode here. All right. So, let's see here. Vibrance does make it a bit more clear what's going on. Yeah. Nathan, you talking to anyone, or is this just you talking to you? Recording.
Are those bins? Yeah, I emptied them yesterday.
Sorry about that. Yeah. So, I'm Flame Tusk. Have a good one.